Okay, Voider, something crazy just happened. I just stepped out of this magazine store behind me and got the new deadline, and watch this. Blind is all over it. There's three pages on it. It's one thing seeing it one like on online and stuff like that, but seeing it in an actual printed magazine, that is a fucking feeling. It's kind of crazy. Ugh, I'm overwhelmed.
Hello, Voiders, and welcome to a fresh edition of I Hate Sundays. As always, during lockdown, we are throwing one of our traditional weekend parties. Oh yeah, and we're starting on a Saturday, of course.
Yes!
Going to the store in our onesies.
Hi.
Yeah, we're totally not like crazy people.
No.
Totally not. Ja, sind echt schon ein bisschen. Wenn
wir
uns jetzt so sehen.
Das ist halt schon
cringe. Getting the booze as Pokemon.
Ich würde Barbie oder Pushkin nehmen, weil Parlament
ist schon voll. Okay,
we gotta go. Wir brauchen auf jeden Fall.
Things are getting hot between the two Felixes.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Wir haben uns über eine Dating App für Felix gefunden.
Felix
times 2. Felix im Quadrat.
So yeah, I finally sat down and watched the remake of The Witches.
Reboot it, renew it, reshoot it, redo it and reuse it, retool it, abuse it, just do it. If you wanna make some easy cash, just recycle and rehash.
Repeat it, reinstate it, reheat it, recreate it. There's no need to feel frustrated, simply just regurgitate it for a guaranteed rating smash. Pick it up out of the trash, come on, just reboot it.
So let's talk the new Witches remake. It was written and directed by Robert Zemeckis, mind you. The same guy who also brought us Back to the Future, Forrest Gump for fuck's sake,
and like much, much more fucking classics. I mean, Death Becomes Her, 13 Ghosts, like, this guy's literally been fucking everywhere. It stars, and watch the fucking cast here. We have Anne Hathaway. We have Octavia Spencer. We fucking got Chris Rock. These are like some names. This is an all-star cast, for fuck's sake. So, this was really set out to be something big. And it feels that way. That's like the impression that I get, because it kind of feels bloated. It feels too much. This is like, I feel like this is one of those cases where less would have been a bit more in this situation. I don't know. This is what I think. Like, you guys gotta like take this review of mine here a bit more with a grain of salt, because I'm usually not this subjective, but I'm gonna be very subjective here. The original film, it has like a special place in my heart, because it doesn't scare me or fuck with me as much as it did with other people. Like, I don't know, I was like 9, 10 when I saw it, so it could have scared me, but like, I was a kid who was used to a lot of shit. Like, I mean, I started watching like horror movies when I was 6, 7 years old. So I had already seen my good fair share of movies like House, like Gremlins, like even like actual Friday the 13th parts already. Like, I was there. I had my share of scary, ghouly, nightmarish flicks behind me. So even though this creeped me out as a kid, it didn't like traumatize me as much as it did with you guys. And I never read the book, even though I am a huge Dahl fan, and I really loved like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Like, when I read that in my 20s, and I got this whole obsession over the whole entire thing. So, but that's a totally different story. I never read the actual The Witches, so the only reference I have from the past where the remake is the actual original film from the 1990s. And what I really liked about this one was that it felt rugged. It wasn't really stylized at all. There was like no CGI whatsoever. Everything was done with practical effects. It almost like felt like a British TV production. I'm not even sure. Maybe perhaps it actually was a British TV production, but I don't know. I really don't know. So, like, I enjoyed its ruggedness. It made the whole entire thing feel very real. You feel very connected with all the characters. It didn't take long to introduce everything, to get the premise started, to set up its little universe. It all just came along. Yes, before I really, like, get into everything, I'm just gonna give, like, a short summary for people who don't know the material at all. The Witches is a story about a young kid living with his grandmother. He stumbles upon a clan of witches and finds out a couple of things. Is kind of at the wrong place at the wrong time, and sees these witches transform one of his friends into a mouse, and when they stumble upon him, they turn him into a mouse as well. So it is basically his job to get back to normal and to expose these witches for who they are. So, like, my problem here already was, like, when the movie starts out, here, we have this huge setup. They really dive into how the relationship between the grandmother and the kid actually, like, forms. Why they are so close. Where in the original, that was pretty much a given. And even though this really gives the movie a lot of depth, I don't really find it necessary. It makes everything feel so much more bloated. It's like you're giving us, like, this whole entire story nobody really asked for. And it's also like such a shame, because Octavia Spencer plays her role so well, and so does Chris Rock. His voice acting is marvelous here, but like, there's this huge in-depth connection between these two characters that you don't really need. Anne Hathaway also does an amazing job playing the Grand High Witch. But then you have the CGI. And I mean, come on. As much prettier as this may look like, it doesn't, like, come close to the grittiness and evil of this. It's just, like, completely two separate worlds. This doesn't seem scary. This is kind of, like, too pretty to be scary. It's almost like this revamped Tim Burton version of the witches, which would be fascinating, but... It also, like, just kind of, like, also feels out of place that, like, there's these superpowers that this grand High Witch has, that she's levitating, stretching out her arms like crazy. It's kind of too much. And... I know it's trying to be, like, the bigger, badder, more sophisticated, revamped version of the original, but it just feels bloated and sort of too much, despite there being so much good work in it. It's kind of unnecessary. It's, like, really a remake nobody really asked for, in my opinion. And... I don't know. I'm usually not, like, really the one saying this, because if you watch older reviews of mine, I'm usually the one who says, like, if something looks too gritty, if something looks too cheap, if something looks very out of date, then a remake is totally worth it. But sometimes the original source material is as cool, or is as charming, or is as good because of this grittiness. So, like, I'm confusing myself a little here. I'm, like, a little, like, almost overwhelmed by how to, like, go about this, really, because I wanted to like this, and it seemed, and I did, but I didn't like it as much as I wanted to. And since we're giving everything so much many more backstories, there's actually even, like, additional characters added in this. Like, in the original, it's just the regular kid and his fat friend who are turned into a mice. But in this one, our kid actually has a pet mouse that can suddenly talk to him. And we later find out that it was, that this pet mouse used to be a girl. It's like they're adding too much shit where nobody was asking them to add anything. So, I don't know. There's things that are, like, good about this and things that weren't that great about this. And I am not sure yet with my rating, really. This is, like, source material that could have been easily a 9, and since it was so overblown, and it just really felt so bloated, it sadly is just a fucking 6 to 7 out of 10. That is all I can give it, but I did like it.
You wouldn't happen to be carrying around a mouse on your person, now would you?
A mouse?
Mm-hmm.
Why on earth would I be carrying around a mouse?
Okay, guys, I'm a little pressed for time to get the Sundays out. We are very, very late, so if you don't mind, I know we were supposed to be doing the list of all our movies this week, but I just want to get the Sundays out as soon as possible. So I hope you don't mind that we do this next week. And now I think I want to, like, end this session by showing you guys our little Thanksgiving party. And what else did I want to say? Yeah, new Movie Void episode's coming up. I will need to get TIFF done by the 10th of December if I want to be in time for our Christmas tradition and bring you guys Silent Night, Deadly Night 4 by the 24th of December. So there's a lot of work I gotta do. So guys, toodaloo, enjoy our Christmas, enjoy our Thanksgiving extravaganza. I'll see you next week. Okay, Voiders. Since I am far away from home and I won't be able to have a real Thanksgiving this year, I decided to make my own little one here. I actually dragged the fucking table that's on the balcony all the way in here to make some shit happen. Looking swell, looking sweet. Still got some shit to do. Gonna have some friends coming right away to help me out. Let's see how this unravels.
Does this work? Or is this too loud? I don't even know how these lights work. I miss my lights in LA.
I'm an Thanksgiving extravaganzas, honestly.
Say hello to the void.
Yes, cheers. I haven't even drank anything yet myself. We're playing Italian music. We say Italian music.
So this is Thanksgiving dinner. I think we did a good job.
Happy Thanksgiving, guys. I hope you all well.
Ryan.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving. Okay, so me and Brian, we made this thing. When we're gonna meet somebody new, the first thing we're gonna say to them on separate occasions, like 2 hours have to pass at least between like the other one says it, we're both going to say, "I know you're suffering" in German, which is "Ich weiß, du leidest."
Von "Ich weiß, du leidest."
Ich weiß, du leidest. Yeah, that's how it would sound. And we're gonna do that. We're gonna fuck some people up like that.
Living life, that's how we be.